Let's begin,
shall we?
Well, hang on.
When I was learning how to code, I was so obsessed with following the tutorial one after another and following different videos on Udemy. Like, you have no idea if you should take the next Udemy courses or if you should just start applying for jobs. Like, when do you know that you're ready to apply for jobs? And if you are thinking about, you know, becoming a developer and actually doing coding as your professional, here is a video for you. So welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, welcome. I am Vicky. If you are currently learning how to code or you are already a developer and trying to build up your career, this might be the perfect channel for you. The first thing you wanted to do is pick a project where you could immediately use the technologies or the frameworks that you just learned. So you might be taking courses like HTML and CSS or some really advanced CSS courses. Any courses that you took from Udemy and you wanted to apply that knowledge immediately in a project. So make sure that you think of a project and think about a project and also projects that you can bundle up and put it on your portfolio. It's really important for you to use the knowledge that you learned from Udemy courses and apply it immediately to an actual personal project. So a lot of the Udemy courses might give you some projects that you can follow along. You need to remember is you need a project that is outside of that tutorial. Again, if you are struggling with project ideas, especially project ideas for you to get hired, I've got another video right here that you can click on it and check out some of the project ideas that would definitely help you to stand out in front of the rest of the people who are applying for jobs. So the second thing is you want to start looking into freelancing opportunities. So thinking about looking for some projects that you can find on Fiverr or even projects that you know that your friends or your family friends that needed a quick website or they need some help with facelifting the existing website, you can actually help them to get you some of those projects. The idea of getting all these projects and freelancing opportunities is not to make money. I mean, it's great that if you can actually manage to make tons of money from that, but the idea is actually getting a real world experience. As a recruiter who are looking for a developer who is perfectly for that position, they want to make sure that this developer is prepared for the real world experience, meaning that they're looking for someone who can work with other people, who can understand what the clients want, and who can communicate with someone who does not understand a lot of technical terms, you know, like your product manager, your project manager, etc. So you want to be able to demonstrate that you can provide some business value by using the skill sets that you learned from Udemy or some other, you know, online courses. This is the key part. You want to show some business value. You also want to have some personal projects in between. So the last advice that I would give you is actually start practicing on going on interviews. Like, there is no such a correlation between being a good developer versus being really good with interviews. Like, it takes a lot of practice to actually be good at communicating technically to a technical recruiter and actually trying to be better at interviewing. Unfortunately, if you wanted to get a job as a developer, you would have to go through that process. There's not really a shortcut for that. You wanted to start getting yourself familiar with interview questions and talking to technical recruiters and practicing on technical interviews. Now, I've come up with a video in the past how to use the Cracking the Interview book, which I'll link somewhere here. You just need to start applying to different jobs because you wanted to give yourself more opportunity to interview and start practicing and getting better at interviews. Don't let the job description scares you. Don't let that, you know, all these criteria that they're looking for in the job description scare you away from applying. Like, apply anyways. If you have, like, you know, 60% of what they're asking for, apply. Like, It's a wish list that they post on the job description. It's not a must list. Like, don't let that criteria scares you, but take it as an opportunity for you to go on to different interviews. Like, you will need a lot of practice until you can actually feel comfortable to communicate technically to the technical interviewer. So make sure that don't let that stop you from applying for different jobs, hence getting yourself more opportunity to interview and practice and being a good interviewee. Okay, so now the other thing that is really important and a lot of people who are on Udemy courses learning to code kind of neglect is the idea of community building. And knowing people and networking and knowing the right people that can get you the right job is super important. The earlier that you start building that community, the easier that is going to help you in the future when you are job searching. And one of the most important factor for that is you need to start contributing to open source projects. And what that means is you need to start looking for projects such as Hacktoberfest, which is a whole month of encouraging open source contribution on GitHub. Once you are started to looking into open source contributions, you really get a chance to look into other people's code and try to read and comprehend a large scale of applications and a larger scale of code bases. That is a really important skill that's developed early down the line when you are looking for a job. One of the popular ways that you can do that is joining online seminars and joining online virtual conferences. I know that now since 2020 it's a little bit different. A lot of things are available online and you can apply to a lot of different conferences. So it's a great opportunity for you to start building your network and start building up your personal connections with other developers and start contributing in a different community. Wow, that sounds like a lot of things you can actually do after you finish Udemy courses. So next time when you're thinking about clicking on another Udemy courses that you wanted to take, stop and really start thinking about the first step, which is looking for a good project for you to actually build with the knowledge and the skills that you learned from the Udemy courses. Don't just keep on following different tutorial after tutorial. Start applying your knowledge with a project that you have in mind. It's a huge journey. Take it a day by a day and take it steps by steps. You're definitely not done yet. If you are trying to figure out what projects that you are trying to build, make sure that you click on the video right here and check out these videos that might give you more ideas about projects that you should be building if you are trying to get a job. If you like this video, make sure that you share the video with people who are also would love it. And also smash that like button and maybe consider subscribing. Until next time, I'll talk to you soon. Bye yo.